past indefinite tense. This tense denote an action in the past. For example, he killed a snake. Next, it is used to denote habitual action in the past. For example, he never told a lie, or he came to me every evening. He studied many hours every day. So it means he's not doing all these things now, but have done in the past. Next is the past continuous. The past continuous is used for an action continuing at a particular time or during a particular period in the past. The chief interest is not the time of action, but its continuity. For example, I was writing a letter when he came to my house. Next, it's used with always, continually, extra for persistent action or habits in the past. For example, he was always ringing me up. Next is the past perfect. The past perfect is used to express an action completed before a certain moment in the past. It is used whenever we wish to say that some action had taken place before another was begun or completed. For example, the patient had died before the doctor came. So, some action had taken place before another was begun. Next, this tense is also used to express some unfulfilled desire. For example, I wish my father had been here at this time. Next, it's used if there are two actions taking place in the past. I had written the letter before he arrived. Here are two actions taking place. First, this one, and the second, before he arrived. So the action that took first is put in the past perfect tense, and the action that took place later is put in past indefinite tense. Next is future indefinite. The future indefinite or simple future is used for an action that has still to take place. For example, they will play a match in the evening. Not now, in the future time, in the evening. Next is the future continuous. The future continuous is used to express an action that's going on at some point in future time. For example, I shall be reading the paper then. So the tense is also used to indicate some future plan. For example, we shall be staying there for a week. The difference between future indefinite tense and the future continuous tense is this, that future indefinite tense indicates some point of time in the future, and future continuous tense indicates some period of time in the future. For example, I shall do this work at 7 a.m. tomorrow, and I shall be doing this work at 7 a.m. tomorrow. So the future indefinite tense shows that the action begins at the stated future moment, and the future continuous shows that the action began before the stated moment in the future. Maybe you start this work at 6 a.m. and still it's a continue. Next is future perfect. The future perfect is used to indicate the completion of an action by a certain future time. Two actions will take place here. For example, she will have cleaned the room before you reach there. The first action is she will have cleaned the room, and the second action is before you reach there. So firstly, you use future tense, and the second we are using here present indefinite tense. Next is the perfect continuous. The perfect continuous is used when an action continues for some duration of time. In order to express the duration of time, the preposition for and since is used. For is used when the period of time taken by an action is to be mentioned. For example, for a month, for 3 years, for a long time. Since is used when the point of time at which the action began is to be mentioned. For example, since Sunday, since breakfast, since yesterday. So the present perfect continuous is used when an action started in the past and it still continues. For example, he has been reading English for 2 years and the action is still continuing. Next is the past perfect continuous. It's used to indicate that the activity was continuous and that it was still going on at the named point or period of time in the past. For example, it had been raining since morning when you rang me up and it still continued. Next is the future perfect continuous. Continuous is used when an action is to continue till some point of time for some period of time in the future. It shows a continuity of an action up to the certain point of time in the future. For example, by 6 o'clock, I will have been sitting here for 10 hours. As by 6 o'clock, I will have been sitting here for 10 hours. So, this is the end of our topic. Thank you.